الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله.
والسلام عليك يا رسول الله.
الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله. وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. نويت سنة الاعتكاف. قال صاحب الآيات، صاحب الدلالات، صاحب العلامات، صاحب الدرجات، صاحب الكرامات، صاحب الإشارات، صاحب البينات، صاحب المعجزات، زمین کے محبوب، زمان کے محبوب، جنین کے محبوب، چنان کے محبوب، یہاں کے محبوب، وہاں کے محبوب، اخیار کے محبوب، ابرار کے محبوب، اشجار کے محبوب، احجار کے محبوب، کاملین کے محبوب، قائدین کے محبوب، اولین کے محبوب، ہر ولی کے محبوب، ہر غوث کے محبوب، ہر کتب کے محبوب، ہر ابدال کے محبوب، رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم. من صلى علی فی یوم خمسین مرة صفحته یوم القیامة. Whoever send درود salvation upon me 50 times a day, I shall shake his hand with him on the day of Qiyamah, on the day of judgment. Sallu alal Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear Islamic Buddhists, before listening to the Bayan, let's make good intention for pleasing Allah Almighty and attain the rewards. The beloved Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has said, Niyatul mu'minu khayru min amalihi. The intention of a mu'min is better than his deed. The more righteous intentions one makes, the greater reward he will attain. Sallu alal Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Salah is the backbone of this deen, the backbone of this religion. And Allah Almighty commands to pray in the Quran. And Allah wants from us to worship Him. This is why we exist on this earth. Allah says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ جِنَّ وَإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, that I have created not the jinn or mankind except to worship Him. And what better act of worship than the act of worship of prayer? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, in a well-known, in a famous hadith, and it's narrated in the Bukhari and Muslim. Buni Islamu ala khamsin. Islam was established, Islam was built upon five main pillars. Shahadat alla ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. Wa akimu salati wa iti zakati wa hajji bayti wa sawmi ramadan. Rabahu Bukhari Muslim. These pillars are foundation of our religion, and Salat takes a large portion of this deen. The Prophet sallallahu ta'ala wasallam encouraged the believers to safeguard the Salah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala wasallam mentioned miftahul jannati Salah, the key for paradise, the key for Jannah, the key for heavens is Salah. We easily forget Salah. In the story of 14 years ago, look at how the Salah was commanded. Because when we look at this history, when we look at the background of the Salah, we have going to realize how important Salah is. The story of Al-Isra wal-Miraj, the night journey. This is the journey whereby the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala wasallam was accompanied by the angel Jibra'il alayhi salam. And he ascends through the heavens, and when he gets to the sixth heaven, it is at this point he greets the Prophet Musa alayhi salam. and then he ascends to the seventh heaven. Then he sallallahu ta'ala reached Sidratul Muntaha. Then the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala reached that place which no one else can enter. The place where intellect and wisdom cannot even reach. He attained a special closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he saw the creator and the owner of the whole universe with his own blessed eyes. And it was on this special night the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala was granted the special gift of 50 prayers, 50 salahs. So he comes back down and meets Musa alayhi salam again at the sixth heaven. And Musa alayhi salam asks him, he says to him, what has Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you? And he says, 50 prayers in the day and night. So he says, go back and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reduce it, for really I have tried with the children of Israel, I have tried with Banu Israel, your people will not be able to handle this. So he goes back and he requests from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reduce the number, and it is reduced by 5. But when he meets Musa alayhi salam again, also says no, go back, and he goes back and the number is reduced again and again until it reduces to 5. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that there are 5 prayers every day, each being rewarded as 10. So that makes 50 times or 50 times of prayer a day. And so even Musa alayhi salam, at this point when he hears about the 5 prayers, when Musa alayhi salam finds out, he goes back, the Prophet says, I have asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to reduce it so much that I am now too shy to ask him to reduce it any further. And so the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam accept what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded, and he comes back down with his command to pray 5 times a day. But remember that for each prayer it is equal to 10 prayers. So in a sense, when you do pray 5 times a day, you're being rewarded as if having prayed 50 prayers a day. Sallu alal habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. What is salah? What is namaz? Salah is the means of us gaining closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salah is the way to communicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salah, it protects us from evils and sins. Salah is the way praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salah is the one calmness of our soul. Salah is the peace of our heart. Salah is Miraj al-Mu'mineen. It is the spiritual journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Salah is everything from us. Salah is the way gaining salvation in the dunya and akhirah. And salah is the coolness of the eyes of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala. My dear Islamic brothers, many, many verses of the Quran tell us about the importance of offering salah. Amin Ahl Sunnah, in one of his bayan, Bayan Namazi Sazai. In the Amir Ahl Sunnat, he mentions many, many incidents about those people who do not offer their namaz. Now, if you pay attention to the words of the Quran, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ, and established your prayer, it doesn't mean that we need to offer our salah, it means establish your prayer. My Islamic brothers, establishing means you must offer namaz on time and every time. There's no such thing that I can't read my Fajr Salah because it is too early in the morning. There is no such thing as someone says that I cannot offer my Isha namaz because it's too late. There is no such thing as that. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ, whatever happens, we have to offer 5 times salah every day. Ala Hazrat rahmatullah ta'alay left for a journey of Hajj for the second time at the age of 52. Allah. Then he rahmatullah ta'alay fell so ill after performing the rites of Hajj that he rahmatullah ta'alay remained bedridden for more than 2 months. Allah. When he rahmatullah ta'alay recovered a bit he got ready to behold the blessed rose of the Holy Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He traveled through a boat and reached a place called Rabiq after 3 days viewing the Jeddah. From there, he rode upon a camel to go to Medina Munawwara. During this journey, when he reached, then the destination was nearby, but very less time was left for Fajr Salah. The camel owner decided to stop the camels